answers to these 7 questions are necessary to determine the veracity of any source of data, big or small. A lot of organizations rely on third-party data in order to enrich theirs, in order to enhance their own and draw more meaningful information out of their data analytics or BI projects. This could be data used for creating a propensity model for customer acquisition, predictive modeling on lapsed clients, user segmentation, and so on. This data could be demographic data, lifestyle clusters, behavior or psychographic data, data on average spending, product usage, shopping behavior for each neighborhood, and much more. Whatever the data is that you want to purchase and consume, these are the 7 questions to ask the data provider to help you better assess its data veracity. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe and hit the bell button to keep getting content about data and best practices in managing it. Now, on to the questions. The first is, who created the original data source? Such a simple question to ask, but often overlooked. Just because someone is selling it, it does not mean that it is trustworthy. Knowing more about the originator of the data source can provide you with a level of confidence in its veracity. Maybe it comes from a phone app, an aggregator, or a governmental program such as a national census, which, by the way, that would be a trusty source of information. Second question is, who contributed to the data source? Well, even though you know who created the original data source, the seller might have contributed to it, or another third party. The data you're purchasing could be from a reseller, which is not a bad thing, but it's something to be aware of. Third question, has the information been edited, modified, or enriched in any way? Sure, you know who the originator of the data is, but was it changed in any way before it got to you? A lot of resellers tend to sell out a specific set of data about a specific domain by aggregating different sources. So when you're purchasing data on shopping behavior, for example, the data could include different sources of similar data that have been combined to offer more complete information. Almost guaranteed, that means the original data was modified in order to match the same metadata and reference data sets. Moreover, the data could have been enriched with other information such as geographical coordinates, as an example. Whatever that enrichment is, again, you should be aware of it. Fourth question, what methodology did they follow in collecting the data? There are several methods of collecting data, each with their advantages and disadvantages that I won't go into, but basically knowing about these details will give you an idea if there was any bias in the results or what the chances of bad data quality might be. Fifth question, what algorithm did they use to match records, and what are the matching confidence levels? If you're purchasing data that have anything to do with your master data, this becomes particularly important. The seller probably won't reveal what the matching algorithm is, as that's usually proprietary information, but you might at least get the variables they used to do the match and the different weights they were given. For example, if you're purchasing product data, you will have more confidence in those that are being matched against the Universal Product Code, UPC, against the Universal Product Code number, the UPC number, as opposed to the product name. Sixth question, were only certain industries or locations included in the data source? Often overlooked because we tend to make assumptions. Let's say we're purchasing data to help us understand where our new restaurant should be located. For that, we might be purchasing some demographic data, behavior data, lifestyle clusters, and shopping behavior. But is it that shopping behavior encompassing all shopping or just food shopping? And if food shopping, what kind of food? Are all the industries included or just some? Lastly, you want to know when the data was produced and collected. The previous questions might have the answers that you were hoping for, but what if the data was collected 5 years ago or longer? Is it still relevant for what you are planning on using it for? Maybe it is, maybe it is not, but you need to know about it and not just assume that it was produced or collected today or yesterday, a month ago. You need to know that exact date. Veracity is rarely achieved in big data due to its high volume, velocity, variety, variability, and overall complexity. In turn, we take solace in understanding that knowledge of data's veracity helps us better understand the risks associated with the analysis and business decisions based on a particular data set, big or small. So find out as much as possible about your data sources to better gauge the veracity. Thank you to the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows to catalog, document, and understand your data with a data dictionary, a business glossary, and ER diagrams. Go get a free trial and check them out for yourself. Additionally, use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. The links are in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Don't forget to check out lightsondata.com. Here you can find out more informative content such as templates and guides, best practices, articles, and other useful information to help you with your data governance and data management questions and challenges. Please like the video if you've enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe to never miss out on great content. Thank you.